Introduction. Many coherence interferometer systems find practical applications for the physical parameter measurement, such as our temperature, strain, humidity, pressure, level, current, voltage, and vibration. Physical implementation and signal demodulation are very important for the good measurement. Many implementations are based on the Bragg gratings, fiber optics, vacuum, mirrors, crystals, polarizer, and their combinations, whereas in the signal demodulation, has been applied commonly the Fourier transform. This transform permits us to know all frequency components of any interference pattern, doing possible the signal demodulation for the interferometer systems. The Laplace transform has many practical applications in topics such as control systems, electronic circuit analysis, mechanic systems, electric circuit system, pure mathematics, and communications. The linear transformation permits us to transform any time function into a complex function whose variable is s equals I omega plus sigma, where I is the complex operator, omega is the angular frequency, and sigma is a real value. The complex function can represent in the complex s-plane, where their axes represent the real and imaginary parts of the complex variable s. This complex plane does feasible the study of dynamic systems, and some applications are the tuning closed loop, stability, mathematical methods, fault detection, optimization, and filter design. In addition, the S-plane permits graphical methods such as pole zero map, Bode diagrams, root locus, polar plots, gain margin and phase margin, Nichols charts, and end circles. In dynamic system analysis, pole zero map and Bode diagrams are two graphical methods which have many practical applications. Both methods require a complex function, where the frequency response plays a very important role. In the pole zero map, poles and zeros have been calculated from the complex function, and then, their locations are represented on the complex s-plane. It is usual to mark a zero location by a circle and a pole location across times. In the Bode diagram, the magnitude and phase are calculated from the complex function, and then, both parameters are graphed. The graphic is logarithmic, and it shows the frequency response of our system under study. Under our knowledge, the coherence interferometer system was not studied on the S-plane, and as a consequence, its interference pattern was not represented over the pole zero map or Bode diagrams. In this work, the complex S-plane was used to represent the output signal of an interferometer system. Applying two graphical methods, such as pole zero plot and Bode plot, the optical signal was represented. Numerically was verified that the pole location and the zero location depend directly on the optical path difference, while a Bode diagram shows the stability slash instability of the interferometer. Interference pattern shows a schematic example of a Michelson interferometer. The interferometer consists of a coherent source, an oscilloscope, a generator function, a beam splitter 50-50 and a PZT optical element. This interferometric system has two ways and its difference produces the optical path difference. The first one will be the reference. Its electrical field is Michelson interferometer system. The second one is the signal measurement and its electrical field is R and AD are amplitudes, omega is the angular frequency, T is the time, and phi R and phi D are given by and XR and XD are the distances traveled by both beams and K equals 2 pi in lambda is the wave number, lambda is the wavelength and N is the refraction index. From, when the photodetector detects the total field, its signal is following, the irradiance ET2 will be developing, we will obtain or using the identity cos theta equals A theta plus E minus I theta 2, 8, takes the form. In terms of intensity, the interferometer system produces the next interference pattern. If both beams have the same intensity IR equals ID equals IO, the total intensity will take the form. As seen in 11, the phase difference is due to the optical path difference between the two beams. Substituting X 3 and 4 into 11, the interference pattern in terms of intensity can be written as where delta x equals xr minus xd is the length difference between the distances xr and xd. Basically, the irradiance is an interference pattern which is formed by two functions, enveloped and modulate. The enveloped function is finv equals 2 iowm2 and this function contains information from the optical source. The modulate function is given by fmod equals 1 plus cos 4 pi in lambda delta xt and it contains information about the interference pattern. The modulate function consists of a constant, direct component, and a trigonometric function, cosine function, whose frequency depends on the optical path difference. Complex function. Observing and 11, the phase difference phi r minus phi d is a time-varying function, and as a consequence, the phase 4 pi in lambda delta xt is also a time-varying function. In this case, the instantaneous output voltage, or current, of our photodetector is proportional to the normalized optical intensity ITT IO, where IO is the laser intensity WM2, BU. Mathematically, the normalized interference pattern can be written as. Here, the angular frequency omega m was proposed from the phase 4 pi in lambda delta xt and the interferometer system has not external perturbations. To determine the complex function ends, we calculate the unilateral Laplace transform for our last expression. Substituting the trigonometric identity cos omega mt equals a omega mt plus e minus I omega mt 2 into 14, the complex function can be estimated through. Or? Solving the integrals, the complex function will be. Evaluating the limits. Using the algebraic procedure, we obtain. As seen in 19, the first term was produced by the direct component and the second term was produced by cosine function. Now, let us represent the complex function as. Because the Laplace transform was used for the transformation, the normalized interference pattern can be studied in the time domain and on a complex S-plane. It is possible since both x 13 and 20 contain the same information. Graphical representation. In mathematics and engineering, the S-plane is the complex plane which Laplace transform is graphed. It is a mathematical domain where, instead of view processes in the time domain modeled with time-based functions, they are viewed as equations in the frequency domain. Then, the function ends can be graphed using the pole zero map and the Bode diagrams. These graphical representations provide a basis for determining important system response characteristics. In general, the poles and zeros of a complex function may be complex, and the system dynamics may be represented graphically by plotting their locations on the complex S-plane, whose axes represent the real and imaginary parts of the complex variable S. Such graphics are known as pole zero plots. It is usual to mark a zero location by a circle and a pole location across times. In this study, it is convenient to factor the polynomials in the numerator and denominator and to write the complex function in terms of those factors. Where the numerator and denominator polynomials, pn's and pd's, have real coefficient defined by the system's characteristic. To calculate the zeros, we require solving last polynomial function, the roots, zeros, are localized at. From our last results, the zeros are imaginary values. By the similar way, to calculate the roots, using our previous results presented at 24 and 26, we represent a pole zero plot for the interference pattern, C. Polo zero map obtained from the interference pattern. From, the interference pattern produces two zeros and three poles. Both zeros S1 and S2 and two poles S2 and S3 are over the imaginary axis and their locations depend on the angular frequency. The pole S1 was obtained by the direct component, our normalized interference pattern and the location are over the origin. Based on the system theory and system graphic representation, the complex interference pattern can be represented through the Bode diagram. The graphical representation permits us to graph the frequency response of our interferometer system. It combines a Bode magnitude plot, expressing the magnitude, decibels, of the frequency response, and a Bode phase plot, expressing the phase shift. As was mentioned, the complex interference pattern can be represented through the Bode diagram. To represent it, the term S is substituted by the term I omega, I is the complex number and omega is the angular frequency, such that 20 takes the form. The magnitude, in decibels, of the transference function above is given by decibels gain expression. Substituting 27 into 28, the magnitude will be applying the logarithm rules, 29, can express as. To determine the phase, 27, will express as. Here, I2 equals minus 1 was used. Last expression can be written as. From, 32, the phase can also be determined. Pole zero plot. In general, the poles and zeros of a complex function may be complex, and the system dynamics may be represented graphically by plotting their locations on the complex S-plane, whose axes represent the real and imaginary parts of the complex variable S. Such graphics are known as pole zero plots. It is usual to mark a zero location by a circle and a pole location across times. In this study, it is convenient to factor the polynomials in the numerator and denominator and to write the complex function in terms of those factors. Where the numerator and denominator polynomials, pn's and pd's, have real coefficient defined by the system's characteristic. To calculate the zeros, we require solving last polynomial function, the roots, zeros, are localized at. From our last results, the zeros are imaginary values. By the similar way, to calculate the roots, using our previous results presented at 24 and 26, we represent a pole zero plot for the interference pattern, C. Polo zero map obtained from the interference pattern. From, the interference pattern produces two zeros and three poles. Both zeros S1 ends 2 and two poles S2 ends 3 are over the imaginary axis and their locations depend on the angular frequency. The pole S1 was obtained by the direct component, our normalized interference pattern and the location are over the origin. Bode diagram. Based on the system theory and system graphic representation, the complex interference pattern can be represented through the Bode diagram. The graphical representation permits us to graph the frequency response of our interferometer system. It combines a Bode magnitude plot, expressing the magnitude, decibels, of the frequency response, and a Bode phase plot, expressing the phase shift. As was mentioned, the complex interference pattern can be represented through the Bode diagram. To represent it, the term S is substituted by the term I omega, I is the complex number and omega is the angular frequency. Such that, 20, takes the form. The magnitude, in decibels, of the transference function above is given by decibels gain expression. Substituting, 27, into, 28, the magnitude will be. Applying the logarithm rules, 29, can express as. To determine the phase, 27, will express as. Here, I2 equals minus 1 was used. Last expression can be written as. From, 32, the phase can also be determined. Intertrieval. As the Laplace transform is a linear transformation, during the transformation, int, the information is not lost and then the interference pattern can be studied in the time domain and on the complex S-plane. In section 2, it was explained the transformation int, and their poles and zeros were graphed over the pole zero map. In addition, we developed interference pattern on the frequency plane, being possible to implement the Bode plot. Following, we recover the time function from the complex function int. This section is didactic since the objective is to verify that the complex function's information can also be represented in the time domain. To recover the time function, we calculate the inverse Laplace transform through. The integral complex is in the S-plane, their limits are gamma minus it and gamma plus it, the symbol L minus 1 middle dot equals 12 pi ilimt gamma minus it gamma plus it middle dot S that indicates the inverse Laplace transform. Substituting, 21, into, 33, the normalized interference pattern can be obtained by applying the partial fraction, 34, can be expressed as. Here, A, B, and care constants. To calculate the constant, we use next equality. Using, 36, we obtain the next equation system and their solutions as. Substituting all constants into, 37, the time function will be. Applying table 1, the solved inverse Laplace transform is. Fundamental Laplace transform. Note, UD is the Heaviside function. Observing both, 13, and, 39, we recover the time function from the complex function. Thus, We confirmed that the complex S-plane permits us to study the interferometer system through the complex S-plane, using the pole zero map and Bode diagrams. Numerical results and discussion. To verify our proposal, we consider the next interference pattern. From 40, the enveloped FIND is a Gaussian function FIND equals 2O equals 2 at 2 and the modulate function is mod equals 1 plus cos 10 t, where the angular frequency is omega m equals 10 radians. If the interference pattern is normalized as 12, we obtain shows the interference pattern and the modulate function. A. The simulated interference pattern. B. The modulate function. Calculating the Laplace transform. Using expressions 24 and 42, the zeros are localized at the points. Now, using eqs 26 and 42, the poles are. Finally, its pole zero map can observe in pole zero plot determined from the complex modulate function 42. As seen in the zeros S1 ANS 2 and the poles S2 ANS 3 are over the imaginary axis. Their positions depend on the angular frequency, and therefore, their positions change due to the variations of the optical path difference. The pole S1 is over the origin of the complex S-plane, and it was generated by the direct component of our interference pattern. To generate the Bode diagram, we consider the next complex function. Combining eqs 28 and 45, the magnitude, in decibels, is where S equals I omega was used. Applying the logarithm rules, the magnitude can calculate as. Using the scientific MATLAB software, we represent its Bode plot, see Bode diagram obtained from the interference pattern. Observing, the magnitude has a small variation between the intervals of 100 to 100.7 and from 101 to 102 while the phase is minus 900. These results confirm the integrative action indicated by 47. The interferometric system produces two asymptotics for the magnitude. First asymptotic is negative, its location is at the point 100.7 and the phase has transitioned from minus 90 to 900. Second asymptotic is positive, its location is 101 and the phase has transitioned from 900 to minus 90. Last interval is between 100.7 and 101. In this case, the magnitude has small variation again but the phase is constant to 90. These results confirm that the interferometer system will have integrative action and derivative action. Here, a complex function was obtained from the interference pattern produced by a coherence interferometer. Considering the pole zero map, poles and zeros depend directly on the optical path difference of an interferometer. The interference pattern generates three poles and two zeros. A pole is over the origin and two poles are over the points plus or minus e omega m. The zeros are over the points plus or minus e omega m2. Now, considering the Bode plot, the interferometer can act as an integrator and as a derivator since the phase can take the value of minus 90 or 90 c. Both graphical representations permit to know the optical path difference through the angular frequency and its dynamic response. From our analysis and results, it is possible to infer a few key points of our novel method. The complex S-plane permits us to study the interferometric systems. The interference pattern can represent as a complex function whose poles are 3 and zeros are 2. Pole zero map gives information about the optical path difference. The pole S1 is over the origin and it was generated by the direct component of the interference pattern. S2 and S3 poles are over the imaginary axis and their position are plus or minus e omega m, where omega m is the angular frequency. S1 and S2 zeros are over the imaginary axis and their locations depend on the angular frequency, c. Bode diagram gives us information about the dynamic response of any interference pattern. Based on the Bode diagram, phase information, the interferometer can act as an integrative action and as a derivative action. The complex S-plane permits us to study the interferometric systems. The interference pattern can represent as a complex function whose poles are 3 and zeros are 2. Pole zero map gives information about the optical path difference. The pole S1 is over the origin and it was generated by the direct component of the interference pattern. S2 and S3 poles are over the imaginary axis and their position are plus or minus e omega m, where omega m is the angular frequency. S1 and S2 zeros are over the imaginary axis and their locations depend on the angular frequency, c. Bow diagram gives us information about the dynamic response of any interference pattern. Based on the Bow diagram, phase information, the interferometer can act as an integrative action and as a derivative action. Based on our results, the interference pattern can be studied by both graphical methods. Those graphical representations can be applied to low-coherence interferometric systems, optical fiber sensors, communication systems, and optical source characterization. Results? To verify our proposal, we consider the next interference pattern. From 40, the enveloped FIMV is a Gaussian function FIMV equals 2IO equals 2 at 2 and the modulate function is FMOD equals 1 plus cos 10 t, where the angular frequency is omega m equals 10 radians. If the interference pattern is normalized as 12, we obtain shows the interference pattern and the modulate function. A. The simulated interference pattern. B. The modulate function. Calculating the Laplace transform. Using expressions 24 and 42, the zeros are localized at the points. Now, using Ex 26 and 42, the poles are. Finally, its pole zero map can observe in pole zero plot determined from the complex modulate function 42. As seen in the zeros S1 and S2 and the poles S2 and S3 are over the imaginary axis. Their positions depend on the angular frequency, and therefore, their positions change due to the variations of the optical path difference. The pole S1 is over the origin of the complex S-plane, and it was generated by the direct component of our interference pattern. To generate the Bow diagram, we consider the next complex function. Combining Ex 28 and 45, the magnitude, in decibels, is where S equals I omega was used. Applying the logarithm rules, the magnitude can calculate as. Using the scientific MATLAB software, we represent its Bode plot, C. Bode diagram obtained from the interference pattern. Observing, the magnitude has a small variation between the intervals of 100 to 100.7 and from 101 to 102 while the phase is minus 900. These results confirm the integrative action indicated by 47. The interferometric system produces two asymptotics for the magnitude. First asymptotic is negative, its location is at the point 100.7 and the phase has transitioned from minus 90 to 900. Second asymptotic is positive, its location is 101 and the phase has transitioned from 900 to minus 90. Last interval is between 100.7 and 101. In this case, the magnitude has small variation again but the phase is constant to 90. These results confirm that the interferometer system will have integrative action and derivative action. Discussion. Here, a complex function was obtained from the interference pattern produced by a coherence interferometer. Considering the pole zero map, poles and zeros depend directly on the optical path difference of an interferometer. The interference pattern generates three poles and two zeros. A pole is over the origin and two poles are over the points plus or minus e omega m. The zeros are over the points plus or minus e omega m2. Now, considering the Bode plot, the interferometer can act as an integrator and as a derivator since the phase can take the value of minus 90 or 90 c. Both graphical representations permit to know the optical path difference through the angular frequency and its dynamic response. From our analysis and results, it is possible to infer a few key points of our novel method. The complex S-plane permits us to study the interferometric systems. The interference pattern can represent as a complex function whose poles are 3 and zeros are 2. Pole 0 map gives information about the optical path difference. The pole S1 is over the origin and it was generated by the direct component of the interference pattern. S2 and S3 poles are over the imaginary axis and their position are plus or minus e omega m, where omega m is the angular frequency. S1 and S2 zeros are over the imaginary axis and their locations depend on the angular frequency, c. Bow diagram gives us information about the dynamic response of any interference pattern. Based on the bow diagram, phase information, the interferometer can act as an integrative action and as a derivative action. The complex S-plane permits us to study the interferometric systems. The interference pattern can represent as a complex function whose poles are 3 and zeros are 2. Pole 0 map gives information about the optical path difference. The pole S1 is over the origin and it was generated by the direct component of the interference pattern. S2 and S3 poles are over the imaginary axis and their position are plus or minus e omega m, where omega m is the angular frequency. S1 and S2 zeros are over the imaginary axis and their locations depend on the angular frequency, c. Bow diagram gives us information about the dynamic response of any interference pattern. Based on the bow diagram, phase information, the interferometer can act as an integrative action and as a derivative action. Based on our results, the interference pattern can be studied by both graphical methods. Those graphical representations can be applied to low-coherence interferometric systems, optical fiber sensors, communication systems, and optical source characterization. Introduction. Turbulence is a commonly seen but very complicated phenomenon in nature. Numerous tests have proven that turbulence is not a pure random process but contains different scales of fluctuations called coherent structures. These structures significantly contribute to fluid entrainment and mass, momentum, and heat transfer. Therefore, investigating the coherent structures is of great significance to undercover the physics and to realize flow control. Among the techniques of turbulence analysis, wavelet transform has been proven feasible in power to detect and extract the coherent structures in turbulence. Early works are based on continuous wavelet transform, CWT. Lyndrant and Jain proposed the maximum energy principle, which considered the signal at the maximum energy scale as the burst events in turbulence. Kim identified the coherent structure around a vibrating cantilever based on CWT. However, a drawback of CWT is that it is unable to reconstruct the signal if the mother wavelet is not orthogonal. To solve this problem, Longo used the multi-resolution analysis technique based on the discrete wavelet transform, DWT, and extracted the structures in turbulence. DWT has evident advantages compared with CWT since it is invertible and multi-scaled scales can be analyzed. Kadosh combined DWT and direct numerical simulation, DNS, whose results prove that coherent structures preserve the vortical structures with only about 4% of the wavelet coefficients but retain 99.9% of the turbulence energy. In this work, measurement of the turbulent boundary layer is carried out using hot film anemometer in a gravitational low-speed water tunnel. A procedure based on the weight and correlation analysis is proposed to extract and verify the coherent and incoherent structure in turbulence. Experimental tests and analysis. A gravitational low-speed water tunnel was constructed for the experiment. The gravity generated by the water level difference drives the water flow in the tunnel, and the flow can be tested in the experimental section. A maximum water speed of 2.0 meters per second can be reached, and the turbulence intensity is less than 2%. The EFA 300 hotwire anemometer was used to measure the turbulence boundary layer flow at a series of positions in the vertical direction. Detailed setups in the experimental section can be observed in. A probe penetrates into the flow to measure the flow field. A coordinate frame was used to move the probe in the vertical direction, with a precision of 0.01 mm. During the experiment, the sampling frequency and sampling time were set to 50 kHz and 10.24 s. Sketch, left, and photo, right, of the gravitational low-speed water tunnel. 1. Water tank. 2. Stabilization section. 3. Contraction section. 4. Experimental section. 5. Electromagnetism flowmeter. 6. Water level observation section. 7. Water pump. 8. Water storage basin. 9. Switch valve. Sketch of experimental setups. 1. PC. E. 2. Hot film anemometer. 3. Coordinate frame. 4. Experimental plate. 5. Hot film probe. By using the experimental setups in, the flow velocity of the turbulence boundary layer was measured at a series of positions in the vertical direction. the mean velocity profile and the turbulence intensity distribution at the water speed 0.4 meters per second can are analyzed in figures 3 and 4, which agree with the turbulence boundary layer theory. This means that the flow field in the experimental section is fully developed. Our setups and techniques are ready for turbulent boundary layer tests. The profile of mean velocity at the water speed 0.4 meters per second. Turbulence intensity at the water speed 0.4 meters per second. Experimental apparatus. A gravitational low-speed water tunnel was constructed for the experiment. The gravity generated by the water level difference drives the water flow in the tunnel, and the flow can be tested in the experimental section. A maximum water speed of 2.0 meters per second can be reached, and the turbulence intensity is less than 2%. The IFA 300 hotwire anemometer was used to measure the turbulence boundary layer flow at a series of positions in the vertical direction. Detailed setups in the experimental section can be observed in. A probe penetrates into the flow to measure the flow field. A coordinate frame was used to move the probe in the vertical direction, with a precision of 0.01 mm. During the experiment, the sampling frequency and sampling time were set to 50 kHz and 10.24 s. Sketch, left, and photo, right, of the gravitational low-speed water tunnel. 1. Water tank. 2. Stabilization section. 3. Contraction section. 4. Experimental section. 5. Electromagnetism flowmeter. 6. Water level observation section. 7. Water pump. 8. Water storage basin. 9. Switch valve. Sketch of experimental setups. 1. PCB. 2. Hot film anemometer. 3. Coordinate frame. 4. Experimental plate. 5. Hot film probe. Verification of turbulent boundary layer flow. By using the experimental setups in, the flow velocity of the turbulence boundary layer was measured at a series of positions in the vertical direction. The mean velocity profile and the turbulence intensity distribution at the water speed 0.4 meters per second can are analyzed in figures 3 and 4, which agree with the turbulence boundary layer theory. This means that the flow field in the experimental section is fully developed. Our setups and techniques are ready for turbulent boundary layer tests. The profile of mean velocity at the water speed 0.4 meters per second. Turbulence intensity at the water speed 0.4 meters per second. Theoretical background of wavelet transform. Weight is a mapping of a time function, in a one-dimensional case, to the two-dimensional timescale joint representation. The temporal aspect of the signal can be preserved. The wavelet transform provides multi-resolution analysis with dilated windows. The high-frequency part of the signal is analyzed using narrow windows, and the low-frequency part is done using wide windows. Weight decomposes the signal into different frequency components and then studies each component with a resolution match to its scale. It has advantages over traditional Fourier methods in analyzing physics where the signal contains discontinuities and sharp spikes. Weight of a signal SD is defined as the integral transform of psi A, B equals 1 A psi T minus Ba, which can be expressed as where phi m, nt is the scaling function, which is defined as phi m, nt equals 2 minus m slash 2 phi 2 minus mount minus n, and where a and b are the scale and position. Scale a and position b should be discretized for applications. Usually we choose a equals 2 millimeters za 0 greater than 1, b equals n 2 mb 0 greater than 0 in z. When psi t obeys the orthogonal condition psi m, nt psi m comma nt dt equals delta m delta n, the functions of the orthogonal basis can be written as. The corresponding dwt can be expressed as. The orthogonality of psi m, nt eliminates the relevance between the points in wavelet space because of redundancy. The analyzing result of weight can thus reflect the characteristics of the original signal. Based on OWT, the signal ST can be written as. By choosing the scale M0 as the critical value, the signal ST can be divided into the approximate and detailed parts. Where psi m, nt is the wavelet function. Phi m, nt can be viewed as a low-pass filter, while psi m, nt as a band-pass filter. The first part of the above equation is the low frequency approximation of the signal ST at the scale 2 minus M0, the high frequency part is the details of the signal ST. For turbulence, the fluctuating velocity of turbulence can be normally divided into two subparts, where S is the coherent part and S is the incoherent part. The signals S and S are statistically independent. By adopting the multi-resolution analysis, the turbulent signal ST can be divided into different frequencies. Coherent structures can thus be reconstructed in a selected frequency domain. Other redundant signals can then be eliminated. Therefore, the frequency range determination and localization of the coherent structures are critical in this process. The frequency can be determined as sketch of the multi-resolution analysis, where fs and fc are the sampling frequency and the central frequency of a particular wavelet basis. A is the scale, denoted as 2 meters, m is a particular level of decomposition, in OWT. It represents the original frequency range of the turbulence signal when an m equals 0, i.e., a equals 1, f equals f0. Extraction and verification of turbulent structures. To extract the coherent structures in turbulence, the signals at the central area of turbulence should be selected. According to previous studies, the formation of the coherent structures in turbulence is formed in the area of zero. Advances in complex analysis and applications. This course is brought to you by Gilad James Mystery School. Learn more at giladjames.com. Introduction. The complex analysis development can establish three fundamental ways of modern research with the goal to solve certain conjectures and complete certain theories as the Lie group's representation theory, obtaining of a general cohomology for certain integral operators in the differential equation's solution and extend these solutions to the meromorphic context. The three ways are defined for the relations between the complex analysis, with a cohomology with coefficients and holomorphic vector bundles, the hypercomplex analysis in a quaternionic algebra and the unitary representations in the Lie group theory. Likewise, some objects as modular forms can be the key for the multidisciplinary investigations in complex functions without the condition that Fc be holomorphic in the upper half plane. Then the modular forms are meromorphic functions. The before can be reflected in the satisfying of the certain functional equation Tfc equals xi, in which the conditions of the complex function Fc respect to the transformation T, can be relaxed and the corresponding modular groups can be smaller groups. Such is the case, for example, for the functional equation of the homographic transformation. The transcendence goes more beyond of the analyticity problems in complex analysis. The study of the complex Riemannian manifolds results relevant in algebraic geometry and strings theories, where complex Riemann surfaces as complex submanifolds can be useful in the determination of integration invariance. Also in the Frobenius distribution for the determination of integral submanifolds as cycles, whose values are cocycles in a spectrum of the category spec, of the category of the complex vector spaces VEC. The theory of Riemann surfaces can be applied to the space G, H asterisk, to obtain further information about modular forms and functions. Likewise, the modular and cusp form spaces MKG, and SKG, for a group G, are of finite dimension, and their dimensions can be computed thanks to the Riemann-Roch theorem in terms of the geometry of the G- action on H, for example to the Lie group SL2Z, this finite dimension is computed as 1. In projective spaces, the functions are homogeneous polynomials. These algebra-geometric objects are the sections of a sheaf, one could also say a line bundle in this case. Precisely here arises the reinterpretation of the differential operators through the homogeneous polynomials of the corresponding lines bundle sections of their respective connections. The each minus invariant on the complex interval minus 22 plus 01 I dot it supports working with modular transformations and evaluating theta sums. With this construction of blocks, one can easily implement other modular forms such as Eisenstein series. http://frederick.net/blog/2014/10/modular-forms-in-arb/. However, there is other conjecture established years ago, which established the sentence. Conjecture 1.1. All complex function, analytic function, FC, can be determined for hypercomplex functions. This could be obtained in a clear way, without pass for the holomorphicity. This represents all a joint research program between the hypercomplex analysis and the integral operators cohomology, and for it is established determine an integral operators theory that establish equivalences between cohomology classes on different complex base spaces and the cycles and co-cycles of these under the corresponding integral operators. Likewise, can be obtained integral representations that are realizations of certain unitary representations of Lie groups such as UN, SU2, SUN, SU22, SUP, and UP, for the obtaining of the general solution of a partial differential equations in context of the quaternion algebra. And not only that, also are contemplated the equivalences of the corresponding cohomology classes obtained through the restricted objects to a space of certain dimension, for example, the hypercomplex analysis in R4C2, and in C4, is a quaternion analysis. Other example we can find in the integrals of the integral geometry of G2,4C, through the space PEC, which establishes a twister geometry. However, the isomorphism relations in homogeneous vector bundles are equivalent to the followed in cohomology developed in vector tomography. Likewise, the intertwining integral operators between cohomological classes of both contexts, respective cycles, result be cohomological classes in contexts of lines bundles, or equivalent co-cycles. In this sense a conjecture that can be proved is, the Penrose transform is a vector Radon transform on homogeneous vector bundles sections in a Riemannian manifold and considering the reconstruction of a Riemannian manifold through cycles, we can consider the following conjecture also. Conjecture 1.2. The twister transform is the generalization of the Radon transform on lines bundles and the Penrose transform is a specialization of the twister transform in S4. A fact, the twister transform can be determined for the Penrose transforms pair on G- orbits of projective spaces P- and P+. Then here arises the mentioned before in modular forms, the use of the lines bundles restricted to the polynomial rings corresponding to the subjacent operators on the complex vector spaces. In a more general sense, the vector bundles which refer us, are the seated in the homogeneous spaces GC/L, with homogeneous subspaces GC/Q, where is subjacent a holomorphic manifold with G- orbits, parabolic orbits, of GC/L, which have an induced Haar measure in each closed submanifold given for the flags of the corresponding holomorphic vector G- bundle. Then their orbital integrals are calculated on set orbits, obtaining invariants applicable to hold the homogeneous space in question, GC/L. This process called of orbitalization of the homogeneous space GC/L, is based in major part in the inclusion of homogeneous spaces obtained for reduction of GC/L, through its holonomy. The spaces or cohomology groups of the complex corresponding of sheaves HSG/HN, result be fine representations of GC/L, through of the flags bundle corresponding to the complex holomorphic G- bundle in GC/L. The realizations of these unitary representations are the orbital integrals on the flags that are the K- orbits of the corresponding vector G- bundle. This is precisely used in representations of G-, a complex Lie group, constructed on spaces of holomorphic sections of vector bundles and generalizations as the studied for the modular forms. The problem that here arise, in the unitary representations, is the verifying of the Hermitian forms calculated through the diverse integral realizations with the corresponding representations choosing the smooth and minimal globalizing, adequate. For it is used in a general version of the complex cohomology known as Macron- cohomology called Serre generalization. However, this is not reduced to the obtaining of representations of complex groups. Also the obtaining of an analytic function FC, of a space to other is realized accord to the integral cohomology in -1-Q-Macron- cohomology HN-1, QCN/DV, where D, is a linearly concave domain on C2. Likewise, for example, if we consider the space C2, the integral operator that obtains a harmonic function in R4, through calculated functions of CC3, on lines S1, in C2, comes given for which represents a transformation in cycles, lines, of a flag manifold F equals LLR4. Likewise complex functions in certain complex manifolds can be obtained through complex or hypercomplex functions defined in complex subspaces, or submanifolds, which could be varieties in an algebraic context, for certain conditions of its cohomology. For example in a complex sheaves cohomology, results interesting for problems of differential equations whose operators are germs of these sheaves. Other study is the singularity study through varieties considering newly the complex varieties, in a pure algebraic treatment, or using the analyticity as a concept required for contour integrals to define a singularity as a pole of an analytic function. Likewise in concrete, through an analytic function study, can be extended and generalized the Cauchy integral as through integrals of contour can be generalized functional in a cohomology of contours, cohomological functional. The Moreras and Cauchy-Gorsatz theorems can be applied in a sense geometrical more general as cohomological functional of contours whose residue value can be modulo LS1 equals 2 pi. For example, two singularities or poles. This could represent the surface of the real part of the function gz equals z2 plus 2z plus 2. The moduli space of these points are less than 2 and thus lie inside one contour. Likewise, the contour integral can be split into two smaller integrals using the Cauchy-Gorsatz theorem having finally the contour integral cgz dz equals c1 minus 1z minus z1 minus 1z minus z2 dz equals 0 minus 2 pi I minus 2 pi I equals minus 4 pi I. This is a good example of traditional cohomological functional element of HF pi minus L apostrophe omega r equals c. As a way to extend the meromorphic functions, the Navan-Lenna theory searches generalizations of extensions of analytic functions to algebraic functions, holomorphic curves, holomorphic maps between complex manifolds of arbitrary dimension, quasi-regular mappings and minimal surfaces. This is being applicable in moduli problems and Shimura varieties. Future research. Finally, the future researches in complex analysis will be centered on major research of meromorphicity, in the automorphicity, biholomorphicity, Riemann zeta function, Hodge theory and the complex ideals for improved methods of homogeneous polynomials in the complex vector bundles studied in complex Riemannian manifolds and their submanifolds, involving singularities as poles or insulated singularities of rational curves. The automorphic forms generalize the Cauchy and Moreras theorems in an arithmetic sense inside the analytic functions theory and their probable holomorphicity. The automorphic forms are the other basic operations that arise inside the mathematics in the modular forms. Introduction. Many coherence interferometer systems find practical applications for the physical parameter measurement, such as our temperature, strain, humidity, pressure, level, current, voltage, and vibration. Physical implementation and signal demodulation are very important for the good measurement. Many implementations are based on the Bragg gratings, fiber optics, vacuum, mirrors, crystals, polarizer, and their combinations, whereas in the signal demodulation, has been applied commonly the Fourier transform. This transform permits us to know all frequency components of any interference pattern, doing possible the signal demodulation for the interferometer systems. The Laplace transform has many practical applications in topics such as control systems, electronic circuit analysis, mechanic systems, electric circuit system, pure mathematics, and communications. The linear transformation permits us to transform any time function into a complex function whose variable is s equals I omega plus sigma, where I is the complex operator, omega is the angular frequency, and sigma is a real value. The complex function can represent in the complex S-plane, where their axes represent the real and imaginary parts of the complex variable S. This complex plane does feasible the study of dynamic systems, and some applications are the tuning closed loop, stability, mathematical methods, fault detection, optimization, and filter design. In addition, the S-plane permits graphical methods such as pole zero map, Bode diagrams, root locus, polar plots, gain margin and phase margin, Nichols charts, and end circles. In dynamic system analysis, pole zero map and Bode diagrams are two graphical methods which have many practical applications. Both methods require a complex function, where the frequency response plays a very important role. In the pole zero map, poles and zeros have been calculated from the complex function, and then, their locations are represented on the complex S-plane. It is usual to mark a zero location by a circle and a pole location across times. In the Bode diagram, the magnitude and phase are calculated from the complex function, and then, both parameters are graphed. The graphic is logarithmic, and it shows the frequency response of our system under study. Under our knowledge, The coherence interferometer system was not studied on the S-plane, and as a consequence, its interference pattern was not represented over the pole zero map or Bode diagrams. In this work, the complex S-plane was used to represent the output signal of an interferometer system. Applying two graphical methods, such as pole zero plot and Bode plot, the optical signal was represented. Numerically was verified that the pole location and the zero location depend directly on the optical path difference, while a Bode diagram shows the stability/instability of the interferometer. Complex function. Observing and 11, the phase difference phi or minus phi d is a time-varying function, and as a consequence, the phase 4 pi in lambda delta xt is also a time-varying function. In this case, the instantaneous output voltage, or current, of our photodetector is proportional to the normalized optical intensity ITT IO, where IO is the laser intensity WM2, BU. Mathematically, the normalized interference pattern can be written as. Here, the angular frequency omega m was proposed from the phase 4 pi in lambda delta xt and the interferometer system has not external perturbations. To determine the complex function ends, we calculate the unilateral Laplace transform for our last expression. Substituting the trigonometric identity cos omega mt equals a omega mt plus e minus I omega mt 2 into 14, the complex function can be estimated through. Or? Solving the integrals, the complex function will be. Evaluating the limits. Using the algebraic procedure, we obtain. As seen in 19, the first term was produced by the direct component and the second term was produced by cosine function. Now, let us represent the complex function as. Because the Laplace transform was used for the transformation, the normalized interference pattern can be studied in the time domain and on a complex S-plane. It is possible since both x 13 and 20 contain the same information. Graphical representation. In mathematics and engineering, the S-plane is the complex plane which Laplace transform is graphed. It is a mathematical domain where, instead of view processes in the time domain modeled with time-based functions, they are viewed as equations in the frequency domain. Then, the function ends can be graphed using the pole zero map and the Bode diagrams. These graphical representations provide a basis for determining important system response characteristics. In general, the poles and zeros of a complex function may be complex, and the system dynamics may be represented graphically by plotting their locations on the complex S-plane, whose axes represent the real and imaginary parts of the complex variable S. Such graphics are known as pole zero plots. It is usual to mark a zero location by a circle and a pole location across times. In this study, it is convenient to factor the polynomials in the numerator and denominator and to write the complex function in terms of those factors. Where the numerator and denominator polynomials, pn's and pd's, have real coefficient defined by the system's characteristic. To calculate the zeros, we require. Solving last polynomial function, the roots, zeros, are localized at. From our last results, the zeros are imaginary values. By the similar way. To calculate the roots. Using our previous results presented at 24 and 26, we represent a pole zero plot for the interference pattern, C. Polo zero map obtained from the interference pattern. From, the interference pattern produces two zeros and three poles. Both zeros S1 and S2 and two poles S2 and S3 are over the imaginary axis and their locations depend on the angular frequency. The pole S1 was obtained by the direct component, our normalized interference pattern and the location are over the origin. Based on the system theory and system graphic representation, the complex interference pattern can be represented through the Bode diagram. The graphical representation permits us to graph the frequency response of our interferometer system. It combines a Bode magnitude plot, expressing the magnitude, decibels, of the frequency response, and a Bode phase plot, expressing the phase shift. As was mentioned, the complex interference pattern can be represented through the Bode diagram. To represent it, the term S is substituted by the term I omega, I is the complex number and omega is the angular frequency. Such that, 20, takes the form. The magnitude, in decibels, of the transference function above is given by decibels gain expression. Substituting 27 into 28, the magnitude will be. Applying the logarithm rules, 29 can express as. To determine the phase, 27 will express as. Here, I2 equals minus 1 was used. Last expression can be written as. From 32, the phase can also be determined. Pole zero plot. In general, the poles and zeros of a complex function may be complex, and the system dynamics may be represented graphically by plotting their locations on the complex S-plane, whose axes represent the real and imaginary parts of the complex variable S. Such graphics are known as pole zero plots. It is usual to mark a zero location by a circle and a pole location across times. In this study, it is convenient to factor the polynomials in the numerator and denominator and to write the complex function in terms of those factors. Where the numerator and denominator polynomials, pn's and pd's, have real coefficient defined by the system's characteristic. To calculate the zeros, we require solving last polynomial function, the roots, zeros, are localized at. From our last results, the zeros are imaginary values. By the similar way, to calculate the roots, using our previous results presented at 24 and 26, we represent a pole zero plot for the interference pattern, C. Polo zero map obtained from the interference pattern. From, the interference pattern produces two zeros and three poles. Both zeros S1 and S2 and two poles S2 and S3 are over the imaginary axes and their locations depend on the angular frequency. The pole S1 was obtained by the direct component, our normalized interference pattern and the location are over the origin. Bode diagram. Based on the system theory and system graphic representation, the complex interference pattern can be represented through the Bode diagram. The graphical representation permits us to graph the frequency response of our interferometer system. It combines a Bode magnitude plot, expressing the magnitude, decibels, of the frequency response, and a Bode phase plot, expressing the phase shift. As was mentioned, the complex interference pattern can be represented through the Bode diagram. To represent it, the term S is substituted by the term I omega, I is the complex number and omega is the angular frequency. Such that, 20, takes the form. The magnitude, in decibels, of the transference function above is given by decibels gain expression. Substituting, 27, into, 28, the magnitude will be. Applying the logarithm rules, 29, can express as. To determine the phase, 27, will express as. Here, I2 equals minus 1 was used. Last expression can be written as. From, 32, the phase can also be determined.